If you run conferences or large events, you might have recently found yourself faced with the decision of canceling your event or trying to host it online. While there's no replacement for in-person interaction, there are ways to still provide a memorable online experience. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to provide an excellent online conference through Zoom. Let's get into it. Hello, creators. I'm Ben Tolson from Podia, where we empower creators like you to make a living doing what you love. The conference experience is hard to beat. Connecting with peers, workshops where you can sharpen your skills and learn new things, groundbreaking keynotes. While creating the same experience online seems like an impossible goal, online tools like Zoom help us get closer than ever. In a previous video, I gave you a checklist of things to remember when planning an online event. But in this video, I'm going to take you through 6 different types of conference events and walk you through how to run those events through Zoom. You can check out this video for an in-depth walkthrough of how to use Zoom to host webinars, which is the main method we're going to use in this video. But for this walkthrough, I'll take you through some of the basic steps. The first conference event type we're going to talk about is keynotes. Keynotes typically include the host or MC who gives introductions, the presenter, and sometimes a Q&A session where the audience is able to ask questions. The Zoom webinar feature is perfect for this type of event because it automatically mutes attendees, creates a Q&A option that can be managed by an admin, and gives the host the ability to appoint one or more presenters. To set up a keynote event from your Zoom dashboard, click Webinars and click Schedule a Webinar. Now type in the title of your conference. In the description, you can fill in details about your conference, but we'll also come back and edit this later. Under When, choose the starting date and then choose the earliest time your keynotes may begin on a given day of the conference. Now set the duration to an hour after the latest time a keynote may end on a given day. Now check Recurring Webinar and select the last day of your conference. Setting it up this way will ensure that you can use the same webinar instance for each keynote, and you can treat the link for this webinar as the main room. Make sure registration is set to Required. Set Host and Panelist Video to On, and under Webinar Options, choose the options that fit with your event. If you have any alternative hosts, enter their emails. Now click Schedule. The second type of conference event we're going to talk about is special events. Special events could consist of musical performances, stand-up, or any other kind of performance-based event. Setting up a special event is similar to a keynote, except in most cases you may not need to use the Q&A feature. It could be fun to keep the chat available so attendees can interact with one another during the performance. You can either plan to use the main room for special events by pointing people to the webinar you scheduled for keynotes, or you can create a new webinar specifically for the event. The third type of conference event we're going to talk about is panels. With panels, where multiple presenters share stage time, the webinar feature is still a great solution. As a host, you can designate as many presenters as you want, and the Q&A feature is great here, especially if you have a moderator who can share questions with presenters throughout the panel session. Again, you can use the main room and point people to the webinar you created for keynotes, or you can create a new webinar altogether. The fourth type of event we're going to talk about is workshops. Workshops typically consist of a single presenter and a limited number of attendees. Depending on how you intend to run the workshop, you could use the webinar feature so attendees are muted, or you could run it as a regular Zoom meeting if you'd like the attendees to be able to participate and ask questions aloud. If you decide to set it up as a regular meeting, you'll follow similar steps that you did for setting up a webinar, except from your dashboard, you'll click on Meetings and then click on Schedule a New Meeting. An important note, if you have multiple workshops with some occurring at the same time, you'll have to set them up through additional Zoom accounts because you can only conduct one meeting or webinar at a time from the same account. The fifth type of conference event we're going to talk about is breakouts or group sessions. Breakouts or group sessions, where attendees get a chance to interact with one another in smaller groups, can also be facilitated in a regular Zoom meeting. The biggest challenge to this type of event is the one meeting at a time per Zoom account limitation. You may need to designate several breakout session leaders and coordinate with them ahead of time to set up each individual Zoom link. Once you've connected with your session leaders, these meetings can be set up the same way you set up the previous Zoom meetings. The sixth and final event we're going to talk about is Hangouts and Mixers. Opportunities for attendees to get together in an informal setting are a staple of in-person conferences, but getting dozens or possibly hundreds of people unmuted on a Zoom call at the same time would be pure chaos. So how do you give people an opportunity to make new connections? This one takes a bit of creativity. we suggest using a similar method to the breakout or group sessions with a little bit of a twist. Have multiple Hangout rooms that attendees can sign up for with specific goals for each room. Maybe one room could be for people who are new to the industry, one could be people who are trying to achieve a specific result in their business, or one could be for people who want to swap virtual business cards. The key is to identify the types of connections people who attend your conferences would typically try to make, and then theme the meeting rooms around those connections. You also want to try to limit the rooms to between 12 and 15 attendees so everyone gets an opportunity to introduce themselves. Once you've scheduled all of your webinars and meetings, go back to the main webinar and edit the description to add the conference schedule along with all of the event links so your attendees and presenters can easily find the event they're looking for. Also, at the bottom of your webinar details page in the invitations tab, click Edit to the right of where it says Approval. This will open up registration options where you can set a registration price and connect a PayPal account to collect registration fees. And now you're all set to run your online event. Have you done or do you plan to do an online conference? Tell us about it in the comments. And as always, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. If you found this video helpful and you want more content like this, click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll be sure not to miss any future videos. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.